The bubonic plague is still killing people all around the globe, but are we at risk and should we be worried? Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and we've all heard of the bubonic plague. It's the devastating disease that eats your body from the inside out and was responsible for the deaths of over 75 million people in the 14th century, including over half of Europe's entire population. What you might not know is that the plague is still around and it's still killing people. A city in China called Yumen was sealed off last week after a 38-year-old man died of the disease after coming into contact with an infected marmot. And 151 others in that city were placed under quarantine for coming into contact with him. But is this the same plague that killed all those people hundreds of years ago? Well, in a nutshell, yes, it is. The plague that existed in the 14th century, now commonly referred to as the Black Death, was caused by a bacterium called Yersinia pestis, and it's almost identical to the one that exists today. That single strain, which was originally transferred to humans by fleas, can cause three separate versions of the plague. There's the bubonic plague, which is the simplest version, the pneumonic plague, which is a lung infection that's rarer but also more devastating than the other two forms, and the septicemic plague, which is the rarest of the three, and it causes all of the blood in your body to clot. Some reports are saying the man in China died of the pneumonic version, while others say it was the septicemic or bubonic version. But it's entirely possible that all three of those are true. The bubonic plague typically appears in localized areas like the lymph nodes, but without treatment, the infection can spread to your blood, morphing into the septicemic version. From there, if it settles into your lungs, it can transform once again into the pneumonic version, which is easily the most contagious form of the three. It's the septicemic version, though, that gives the Black Death its name. The lack of blood flow causes your extremities to turn black until your limbs literally fall off. And all of this can happen within a span of 24 hours. It's terrifying stuff, and even though the bubonic plague still exists, even in developed countries like the United States, it's now completely curable with antibiotics. Just last week, four Colorado residents were diagnosed with the pneumonic plague after coming into contact with an infected dog. All of them have now been treated, and they're expected to live. But the man who died in China likely didn't have access to antibiotics, which explains why such drastic measures were taken. Disease control specialists quarantined all 30,000 residents in Yumen for 9 days to perform disinfection as well as extermination of all the rats. They also ran education sessions to raise awareness of how people can guard themselves against infection. As of today, the quarantine has been lifted and no more deaths are expected, at least for now. People who live in rural areas with lots of rodents are far more at risk than the general population, but it still stands that anyone can theoretically contract the plague. As long as you catch it early, though, and have access to antibiotics, there's really no need to worry. Yay, modern medicine. As always, if you guys have questions, comments, or anything you want to say about this episode, just leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.